Howdy, folks! In the previous video, I already shared with you how to create private proxy from VPS DigitalOcean. In this time, I still guide you how to create private proxy, but it's from VPS Vultr. There has some basic differences between creating proxy from VPS DigitalOcean and VPS Vultr. First, the cost. The lowest cost package to create VPS on DigitalOcean is $4 per month, while on Vultr is $5 per month. Second, a new account on DigitalOcean can create maximum 10 VPS, which are equivalent to 10 private proxies, while you just can buy one VPS and create only one proxy on Vultr. Moreover, according to my personal experience, using proxy from VPS Vultr has more stable speed and less flicker. To create VPS on Vultr, first, you log in Vultr account that you already registered before. Select Products tab in the left column. In Instances section, click the circle icon. Select Deploy New Server. Choose Server section has four types of virtual servers suitable for different needs and levels. Choose the most popular cloud compute, shared vCPU, with prices starting at $2.50 per month. In the CPU and Storage Technology section, select Regular Performance to save costs. The Server Location section is to choose where to place the server. I always choose the location near my country, which is Singapore and in Southeast Asia, so it ensures the fastest and best access speed. Operating System section belonging to Server Image is to select the operating system among Linux and Windows operating systems here. You can choose the appropriate VPS operating system, but I still recommend using Ubuntu because it's easier to configure. Next, I chose the 20.04 LTSX64 version because I was used to using this version and found it relatively stable. For server size, I choose the package with the lowest cost, which is $5 per month. In Add Auto Backup section, you can optionally enable or disable this feature. Turning on this feature will help you recover your entire VPS, website, application when the server has a problem or the website is corrupted or hacked. The cost when turning on this feature is 20% of the price of the VPS package that you use. For example, I use a package $5 per month. If auto backups are enabled, the cost will be $1 per month, a total is $6 per month. For SSH keys, I have already entered it before. Next, give the VPS a name and label in the server host name and label section. For example, I set mine as my private proxy. Remember not using spaces or special characters when naming. Finally, double-check all options before clicking Deploy Now. You will wait about 10 minutes to create VPS successfully. Click VPS that you have just created. Type git cmd to search in the Windows search bar. Log in with SSH root and copy IP address of the new VPS. A question will appear on the screen like this: are you sure you want to continue connecting? Then type yes. Copy password from Vultr interface and paste it into git cmd. To update the latest data of all packages in the operating system, type the command apt-update. After the information has been read and upgraded, type apt-install squid to install squid proxy. To configure squid, type the command. Add hash before HTTP access, allow localhost. To allow all other access to this proxy, change the command from deny all to allow all. Next, scroll down to change the default port from 3128 to 31280 to increase security. Press Ctrl plus X to exit Nano. A question will appear on the screen like this: save modified buffer, then type Y, yes, to save the changes. Finally, to restart Squid Proxy, type the command. Type the command of status to check status uncomplicated firewall. Type the command. Finally, I have already created my private proxy from VPS Vultr. To check proxy information just been created, you can check it through website HUR. Now, you see, my IP is currently located in Singapore. In the next video, I will share how to set up a proxy server in Firefox. If you love this video, support me by giving like, subscribe and click the notification button to be able to update the video as soon as possible. Goodbye and see you again.